Here we're going to look at a second order reaction in which water reacts with acetic anhydride in a steady state continuous stirred tank reactor. And so first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to pause, make a diagram, label the information that we know. So I've listed the information that we know, the order of reaction, first order with respect to A and respect to W, where A is acetic anhydride. And what I want to do next is write down mass balances. First, I write a mass balance for the acetic anhydride. Steady state, so there's no change respect to time. I have molar flow rate, so this is moles per time of A coming in. Molar flow rate leaving, and that's different because of the rate reaction. So the rate reaction, R sub A, is per volume. And I can write this in terms of a volumetric flow rate and a concentration. And since this is liquid phase, mostly water, the volumetric flow rate's not going to change significantly, so we'll assume it's constant. And then we have the rate of reaction times the volume of the reactor. Well, I'm going to do the same thing for water. So let me pause and write down the same corresponding equation for water. Well, these equations aren't too complicated, that I could probably solve them analytically, but in reality, if we want to get used to also solving such equations when we have energy balances, they're going to be more complicated, have exponential terms in temperature, etc. It's easier just to do it numerically. So I'm going to show you a numerical solution. Since you have these two equations and then the other information I need to put into this solution, I'm going to write down now. And then I want to double check to make sure the units are consistent, that each term in this mass balance corresponds to moles per second. So I can add and subtract them. And what I'm going to show you now is a polymass solution that gives us the final answer. And the final answer, concentration of A leaving 0.081 moles per liter, and the concentration of water doesn't change so much, of course, because we have so much more water, but we react at most of the Ca. And then I can calculate the conversion from those numbers. The conversion of A, since that's the reactant we're interested in, that's also a limiting reactant. When it's a constant volumetric flow rate, it's how much reacted over how much entered the reactor. And so we substitute these numbers. So the conversion, which is what we're interested in, is 0.97 to two significant figures, so 97% of the acetic acid is converted in this CSTR. So let me show you the polymath program that got us that result. So this is the polymath program to solve nonlinear algebraic equations and essentially put everything on the right side of the equation and this function here and here. The program is going to get that to zero by adjusting Ca and Cw. So you can see in this reactor that we used an excess of water so that we could convert most of the acetic anhydride.